Knocks out even the toughest weeds fast.
1, 2, 3, it's over!
Gary.
I was reading about this guy named Bernie Krause who records nature sounds for film and television. And he was saying that in 1968, in order to get 1 hour of undisturbed natural sound, like no airplanes, no cars, it would take him about 15 hours of recording time. And he was saying that today, in order to get that same 1 hour of undisturbed sound, it takes him 2,000 hours of recording time. It reminds me of the story of one of the great Jewish prophets, Elijah, who's been going and going, and he's just about at the end. And he's just totally stressed, just totally fried, and doesn't even know if he wants to go on. And God says, Elijah, go up on the mountain because I'm going to show up. And so Elijah goes up on the mountain. And so this wind comes on the mountain, and it like shakes the mountain violently, but God isn't in the wind. And then there's this earthquake, but God isn't in the earthquake. And then like this massive fire covers the mountain, but God isn't in the fire. And then comes the still, small voice of God. Now, there's all this discussion about what exactly this voice is, because some people think that the actual Hebrew word doesn't even refer to a sound that you could like hear with your ears, like an audible noise. And so some translators translate the phrase that God was in the sound of sheer silence. God wasn't in the wind. God wasn't in the earthquake. God wasn't in the fire. God was in the silence.